Good afternoon. This is P.R. Hampioli again from GIT Engineering College, Belgaum. Today we are there to discuss a fine algebraic structures known by the name rings. In some of the few classes, you might have studied one more basic algebraic structure known as groups, where it gives a fine structure to any set. Set is not so useful because it has no facility of addition, subtraction, multiplication, identity element, unit element, and so on. So, one step ahead of groups is ring theory. So, for MCA students, for CSIS, you have to learn one step ahead of these group theory rings. Small fundamentals are there. So, let us take one by one. Quickly, we shall define, just to revise the definition of group theory also. And afterwards, we have to add some few more conditions for to make a group as a ring. So that we shall see that you understand this ring theory, the basics and fundamentals of that, what is the difference between groups and rings, and given a set and operations, whether it is a ring or not, fundamental things we should understand. Afterwards, if once we understand rings, then what are the different types of rings, that also we shall understand. So quickly we shall see first some examples, what makes a set a ring. Shall we see some examples? So today, let us understand what is meant by ring. In algebra, let me take set of integers, usually we denote it by minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3. So what are the qualities of this set? See, first one is, if I take any two elements belonging to this set Z, and if I add them by suppose usual multiplication, sometimes this becomes unusual usual addition, sometimes this becomes unusual addition, A plus B equal to some C also belongs to the Z. For example, suppose I take 5 and 6, then if I add them it becomes 11, all 5, 6, 11 are in Z only. Adding any two integers is one more integer. I may take some negative number also, minus 4 plus 8 is also plus 4, belongs to Z. This is a closed property, that is what we call addition and Z combination. When we take Z is closed under addition. Apart from this, can you observe that zero property? Whenever there is a set like this, if at all there is a zero, where if I take any element of Z and add that 0 in any fashion, I get back A. That is, we are having one 0. In matrices, this will not be 0. In matrices, the 0 will be 0 matrix. So that 0 has got different formats. So now in vectors, 0i, 0j, 0k, in matrices, some 0, 0, 0 structure for 2 cross 2, for 3 cross 3, 3 rows, 3 columns, 0, 0, 0. So this need not be the only 0. According to the set we take, if I take matrix, this 0, if I take vectors, this 0, if I take integers, this 0. So let us write down this property as, this is also known as zero property or identity property. So we have listed two properties. Number one here, binary operation closed. Second one, 0. You can observe that for every element like 2, suppose there is minus 2, and if I add 2 and minus 2, it is going to become 0. 2 and minus 2 are known as inverse of each other. Similarly, 3 and minus 3, for 0, 0 itself is the inverse. By combining two numbers of this element, if the output is identity element, then those two numbers are inverse of each other. That is, if A plus B or B plus A is 0, then we say that B is, just to denote them, B is minus of A or B is inverse of A. So this we call it as inverse property. In number theory, inverse is for 2 it is minus 2, for 3 it is minus 3. But in matrices theory, inverse is for a matrix A, its inverse matrix, if it exists, becomes the inverse of the matrix. So according to the set, again we have got different inverses. So apart from this, one more property this set enjoys apart from this, if I take any three numbers, suppose A, B, C belonging to this integer set Z, and if I add them in any fashion, that is, first if I add them A plus B or B plus C, then grouping will not change the addition. So this is known as associative property. So if these four conditions are satisfied, you have already learned that because of these four conditions, Z becomes a group under addition is a group. Now we have not taken multiplication into account. Now if I take multiplication into account, then I am having two operations. One is addition and one more is multiplication. So let us take multiplication also into account. So suppose if I add one more axiom about this Z, if I take multiplication as usual multiplication, if I take any three numbers A, B, C, observe this, and if I multiply them in any fashion, first A, B, then C, or first B, C, then A, then it is also going to remain the same. It is, apart from some properties with respect to addition, we are going to have added property with respect to multiplication. This multiplication is usual multiplication for integers, real numbers, natural numbers, and it is a different multiplication for matrices, and it is different multiplication for vectors. Hence, this is associative for dot. Sixth one, I combine both properties A into B plus C. This will be same thing as A into B plus A into C. Many of you might have heard of this property, distributive property. So there can be one more distributive property. I have multiplied by left side to B plus C. I can multiply to the right side to the B plus C. That is, B plus C dot A is B dot A plus C dot A. This is exactly known as multiplication is distributive over this addition with respect to integer set. If a set satisfies all these six conditions plus one more condition here, that is, let me write that also, which is B plus C dot A equal to B dot A plus B dot C dot A. So left multiplication, right multiplication, both the distributive laws are true. So if at all a set satisfies all these six axioms, six rules, then with respect to Z plus and dot, set with these two operations will be called as ring. So Z plus dot becomes a ring. Not only this set of integers. Very similarly, I can take set of rational numbers. Shall we see the set of rational numbers, please? Yes. Rational numbers usually denoted by Q. This consists of fractions, negative, positive, zero, integers. So minus 3 by 2, minus 1 by 2, and 0, 1 by 2, and minus 4, minus 5, etc. 1 by 3, 1, 2, 3, etc. So it is a set of all integers together with proper fractions, that is, fractions in the form of P by Q. So now, this is also a fraction, of course, 1 by 1, 2 by 1, 3 by 1. Now, if I take any two rational numbers, like for example, 1 by 3 plus 2 by 5 by 3, I am going to get 8 by 3. This is also a rational number, belongs to Q. Rational number means a number which is of the form P by Q. P is integer, Q is integer, Q not equal to 0. So now, any two numbers, if I take from rational number, then addition of these two becomes one more rational number. So rational number is also closed under addition. Similarly, this set also contains a 0. 0 belongs to rational number, or there is a identity element with respect to addition. So first property closed, second property identity element, third property. As we saw that inverse is the third property, inverse is possible here also. For every A by B, there is minus A by B, and if I add these two, I am going to get a 0. For example, for 2 by 3, there is minus 2 by 3, and combining these two with respect to the addition, we are going to generate identity. That is, rational number set also, for every element A, there is a negative of that. Combining those two, the output will be 0. So, like this, there is a inverse property for this also. Fourth one, rational number set is also associative A plus B plus C with respect to addition A plus B plus C. That is, whether I add two fractions or three fractions, for simplicity I have taken all same 1 by 2, 3 by 2, 5 by 2. See, output will be the same, like 1, 3, 5, 9 by 2. You can very easily check. That is, rational number set is also associative. Apart from this, two more conditions. Only this much is satisfied, then we are going to have group. But we want to have one more type of group known as abelian group. I will come to that. Abelian. For all AB belonging to Q, A plus B is equal to B plus A. This is happening here also. This is happening here also. This is also abelian, because if you add any two integers, A plus B is equal to B plus A. Similarly, if I add any two fractions, A plus B equal to B plus A. So that rational number set or integer set is an abelian group first of all. Afterwards, apart from abelian group, it has three more conditions. One is association with respect to multiplication, distributive of multiplication over addition. Here also, this is associative with respect to multiplication. For example, 1 by 2, 3 by 5, 6 by 8, you multiply in any fashion 1 by 2, 3 by 5, 6 by 8. You multiply in any fashion, you can very easily see that. So, apart from this, we have got similar distributive law true for a rational number set also. Can you take real number set? Yes, we can take a real number set also. That is, instead of this, if I take a real number set which is R equal to, I may have all types of minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, minus root 2, minus 1 by 2, 0. And all positive values 3, 2, 1, root 2, root 3, 1 by 3 and so on. That means purposely I wrote all these different combinations. It can have thirds like root 2, root 3, root of 2 plus 3, minus of that, negative thirds, positive integers, negative integers apart from 0. So, set of all these, union of all these is a real number. Exactly what is a real number? Real number is a number, if you square it, it should be greater than or equal to 0. That is the definition of real number. If I combine any two real numbers, the output is a real number. So, wherever R is there, Z is there, I can go on writing R. There is a 0 element for real numbers also. That is, if I add this 0 to any real number, then for all A belonging to the real number set, again I am going to get the output as the same. Similarly, for every real number like root 2, there is minus root 2, 1.3, there is minus 1.3, half, there is minus half. For every real number, there is a inverse of that. Apart from that, real number is abelian, A plus B equal to B plus A. Real number is also abelian, A plus B equal to B plus A. 2 plus root 2 equal to root 2 plus 2, root 3 plus 5 equal to 5 plus root 3. First of all, real number set is becoming a abelian group. Apart from abelian group, if you take any three real numbers A, B, C, then you can have A dot B dot C equal to A dot B into C. Similarly, the distributive law is also true. You take an example for this, A dot B plus C equal to A dot B plus A dot C. Suppose I take one example for that. What is the example you can take? Suppose A is our root 2, B is 1 plus root 3, and let me take only simple thing, 1 by 5, and this is minus 3. So, different, one is third, one is fraction, one is integer. Then what is the meaning of A dot B plus C? E dot B plus C gives us root 2 dot 1 by 5 plus, let me take for simplicity, plus 3 plus 3. This is also equal to root 2 dot 5 plus root 2 dot by 3, that is root 2 into 1 by 3 or exactly 3. What is the meaning of this? A dot B plus C is equal to A dot B plus A dot C. This is our A, these are our B and C's. So, distributive law is also true in the real numbers. So, real number set also becomes a ring. What is the quality of ring? We have seen for three examples. Further ahead, if I take a set of complex numbers, then also this becomes true. So that, let us quickly write in a nutshell set of complex numbers. So complex number set, if I take C equal to, they are something like 2 plus 3i, 2 minus 3i, only I, 2i, minus I, minus 2i, and even I can include all 5, 6, 7, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, including 0. That is complex number of the form A plus IB, where A and B are real numbers. Complex number of the form A plus IB, where A and B are real numbers. They may be integers, where 5 plus 0i, 7 plus 0i, minus 3 plus 0i, or they may be pure complex numbers like this, which is 2 minus 3i, 2 plus 3i. So, all these together, what happens? First property, if I add any two complex numbers, suppose C1 plus C2, then resulting C3 also belongs to the complex number set. A 0, which is 0 plus I0, is there for complex number set, also there in the complex number set. That is closure property, 0 property, identity property. For every complex number C1, there is a minus C1, addition of these to become some 0 plus I0. For example, for this, 2 plus 3i can become minus 2 minus 3i. So, it is a inverse. If I add these two numbers, definitely minus 2 plus 2 is going to become 0, 3i minus 3i is going to become 0. Similarly, can you tell me the complex number root 2 plus 3i, what is the minus 3i, what is the negation of this? Negation of this is minus root 2 plus 3i. If I combine these two by addition, we are going to get root 2 minus root 2 cancelled, minus 3i plus 3i cancelled. Hence, I am going to get 0 plus 0i. So, this complex number set is also going to satisfy all the group conditions. Apart from this, product of two addition of two complex number is commutative, C1 plus C2 equal to C2 plus C1. Apart from this, it is associative with respect to multiplication, it is distributive with respect to multiplication and addition. So, complex number set is also a ring. So far, we are discussing what is a ring, but let us discuss what is not a ring. Some sets are not rings, for example, but before that, let me give one more example. Can you consider this set? Minus 4, minus 2, 0, 2, 4. Can you observe? This is a set of even integers. Set of even integers. If you add any two even integers, the output is going to be even integer. So, hence it is closed with respect to addition. 0 belongs to the even integer set. For understanding, let E be the even integer set. For every even integer A, there is a minus A. For example, for 4 there is minus 4, for 6 there is minus 6, reverse is for minus 10 there is plus 10, which are inverse of each other. So, closed is there, inverse set is there. Apart from this, if I take any three real numbers and add in any fashion, which is A plus B plus C, is A plus B plus C like this. For example, 2, 4, 8, you add in any fashion, 2 plus 4 plus 8. Of course, these are very, very simple, but when it comes to matrix addition and different types of addition, that time when we check this, any addition, addition is a usual addition here. Suppose, for example, I can define one addition like this, A plus B is our usual A plus B minus 1. This is a different type of addition. But this type of addition also becomes a, all these properties becomes true for the set of rational number or integers or real numbers or set of, may not be for the set of even numbers. For example, here what happened, even number set also is satisfying 1, 2, 3, 4, all the properties. Apart from this, with respect to dot also this becomes associative, with respect to dot n plus this becomes distributive, hence even number set is also a ring. But I was interested in telling what is not ring. What is not ring? Let us see. Instead of even number set, if I take odd number set, what happens? That is minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, then 0 is not there, there only we can stop, here only we can stop. For a group or a ring, there should be a 0 element. So 0 itself is a missing, first one. Prove that odd number integer set is not ring. How do you prove it? To disprove that, or to prove that it is not not ring, to prove that any set is not ring, at least one of the rules like closure property is not true, 0 is not there. At least if one fails, it becomes not ring. For example, here if I take any two odd numbers, and 4 is not odd number. So hence odd number set is not closed under addition. This is enough. Even somebody can tell that 0 doesn't belong to odd number set, identity element doesn't belong to odd number set, hence this is not a ring itself. Now we have to have still superior rings, and what are the different properties of rings? Once having understood what is a ring, let us see the definition of ring in total. In total, let us take capital R as some set. In total, let us take capital R as some set. So R is going to be the ring if, first condition, R should be abelian group. Abelian group means all those closed property, zero property, inverse property, and associative property. Apart from that, A plus B equal to B plus A, commutative property. So 5 properties for abelian group. Apart from that, it should be associative with respect to dot. So these conditions are extra conditions apart from group. That is the difference between group and ring. What is the difference between group and ring? Apart from these conditions, it has multiplication properties, 2 extra, one is associative, one is, it is A dot B dot C equal to A dot B dot C, ordered, arranged in any fashion for all ABC, for all ABC belonging to this set R, this set R. Apart from this, again for all ABC belong to this, distributive property is true, which is A dot B plus C should be equal to A dot B plus A dot C, or B plus C dot A should be equal to B dot A plus C dot A. So today the first step what we learnt is R is a group. If R is a ring, let R be, R is set, then R is said to be ring. A set R is said to be ring with respect to two operations, plus and dot. This plus and dot need not be always usual plus and dot what we are taking. That is what I was telling, with respect to matrix this becomes different type of addition, this dot becomes different types of multiplication. In vector theory, this addition is component wise addition, this dot becomes different types of multiplication. Similarly, in modulo operations, modulo 5, modulo 6, addition is different, dot is different. Similarly, we can have different types of rings. Having understood the meaning of ring, and having understood one example which is not a ring, that is odd number set is not a ring, let us proceed ahead to understand better and better things. So that if I see the examples of different examples of ring, then we will come to know that what are the different qualities. So far we have taken some very few properties of product. Now let me come to the some special types of rings. before coming to some special types of rings, can you imagine what are the rings just like in groups? Let us recollect, if R is a ring, then R contains definitely 0, just like 0 should be there, or identity should be there, because R is a group also. So it is simple that why a ring should contain 0, the answer is because R is a group structure also. These are all known as algebraic structures. So in algebraic structure, groups and rings, and afterwards so many things are there, ideals, integral domains, field. So here after group you are learning rings. So because R is a group, again for all a belonging to R, there should be minus a. Usually we denote inverse of a by notation, by minus a, negative of a. This minus sign does not indicate that always it is a real minus sign. It can be different minus sign, like in a plus a minus b can be different a minus b plus 1. Now let us one more thing, apart from identity and inverse, this should be commutative, a plus b equal to b plus a, but these two are important for us. Some more, this can be taken as remark for a ring. So what is the difference between group and a ring? Apart from it, has group has no associative with respect to multiplication, group has no distributive law with respect to multiplication and addition. So now, having understood this, some more conditions I have not taken. What is meant by identity in general? With respect to addition, identity is 0. Why? Because by 0, adding 0, it will not change. Similarly, with respect to multiplication, the identity is 1, because if I multiply a into 1 or 1 into a, this is going to remain the same. This identity element we have not so far imposed in the ring structure. That becomes a special case. So let us come to the special cases, special rings. In special rings, suppose I first take commutative ring. What is commutative ring? Already we know that ring is commutative with respect to addition, because it is abelian group, but we have not told that it is a dot b equal to b dot a always. So if a ring R is commutative with respect to the second operation dot also, then R is said to be commutative ring. For example, integer set 2 into 3 equal to 3 into 2, rational number set a1 by b1 into a2 by b2 equal to, you can reverse the order, a1 by b1 a2 by b2 is same thing as a2 by b2 into a1 by b1. So commutative is there true in z also, that is integers. Commutative is true in rational numbers also, that is q. Similarly, commutative is wherever commutative is true apart from the usual ring structure, then R is known as commutative ring. Which is not a commutative ring? Suppose A is a set of all matrices of order n cross n. Then under usual matrix addition and matrix multiplication, this becomes a ring. Is it a commutative ring? No, because if I take two square matrices of same order, AB and BA need not be equal, because matrix multiplication is not commutative. So that prove that matrix multiplication is not commutative. Not commutative ring means simply you take two examples, 1, 1, 1, 2 and into 1, 2, 3, 4. Similarly, you show that 1, 2, 3, 4 into 1, 1, 1, 2. Show that these two products are not equal. That finishes proving that it is not a commutative ring. Though it may be a ring, it is not a commutative ring. But whereas other structures like Z, Q, complex numbers, all are commutative rings. Is even number set like minus 4, minus 2, 0, 2, 4, even number integer set is commutative ring? Yes, it is a commutative ring. It is a commutative ring. Next to commutative ring, we have got what is known as identity, ring with unity. Second one, ring with unity. Unity means one. Z contains one. Unity with respect to multiplication. Z contains one. Real numbers contain one. But see this example, this doesn't contain one. So this is a commutative ring without unity. Similarly, the reverse example, matrices. In matrices, in matrix, suppose of order 3 by 3, 1 0 0 1 0 0 0 1, this acts as our 1. See, this 1 also differs from set to set. So this is not commutative, but it has a unity. So matrix theory is a commutative, non-commutative ring with unity. Integer set is commutative ring without unity. So similarly, the different permutation combinations can be taken. So some more examples of a ring can be told, but before that, quickly see, let us see so far what we have discussed. So let us see so far what we have discussed, but concentrate on the set Z of all integers is closed under usual addition and usual multiplication. After observing this, Z is abelian group under addition, that is all the 5 conditions of group theory are satisfied. These 2 are extra conditions. The operation multiplication is associative, the operation dot is distributive over the operation in Z. So that we are going to have this operation distributive means multiplication. Sometimes I have used dot, or sometimes here some other like structure, A dot B plus C is A dot B plus A dot C. Or in the right side also, if you multiply, A dot C plus B plus B dot C is same thing as A plus B dot C. All together we define a ring. Definition of ring: let R be a non-empty set. Non-empty is very important. If you forget that word, you may lose some marks. Let R be a non-empty set which is closed under two binary operations. Closed under two binary operations. Say addition is plus and multiplication is dot. These are not usual, always usual addition and multiplication. They may change their structure. Then together with these operations, R is called a ring provided the following conditions hold. First one is R is a abelian group under the operation plus. Operation dot is associative in R, that is A dot B dot C equal to A dot B into C. And apart from this, this operation dot should be distributive over addition. A dot B plus C equal to A dot B plus A dot C. A plus B dot C equal to A dot C plus B dot C. For all ABC belonging to R, there should not be any exception for this. Now, having found this, what is the important remark? This plus and dot are not usual addition multiplication. For this, usually we write this as addition, this as multiplication. But in an abstract sense, second one, in a ring, the roles of plus and dot, very important, see here, they, you cannot interchange this. Why? Why? Because ring is a group under addition, but it is not a group under multiplication. I am repeating, ring is group under addition, but it is not group under multiplication. So having said the second remark, see the important remark here. Since a ring is a group under addition, it should have a zero element, some zero element. For matrix theory, zero is zero matrix. For number theory, it is ordinary zero. Similarly, identity element, if at all, exists. So zero element, if exists, it is unique. Only one zero element will be there. Identity element in a group is also unique. So that other than zero, whatever the elements are there, we call them as non-zero elements. Now, since a group is a ring is a group structure, every element has additive inverse. See, that is important. Need not be having multiplicative inverse because it is not a group under multiplication. That is, we usually denote every inverse of every element A by minus A. It should be noted that inverse of inverse is the number back. Minus of minus 2 is plus 2, something like that. So now, since a ring is a group under addition, since cancellation laws hold in a group, the cancellation laws hold in a ring also. For example, just quickly, what is the last meaning of last remark? Can you see here? Cancellation law with respect to addition, please. 2 plus A equal to 2 plus some 6. Then left cancellation law holds in with respect to addition. So A equal to 6 we can write because it is a group. Similarly, we can write it for a ring also. because ring is a superstructure of the group. Similarly, this is known as left cancellation law. Similarly, right cancellation law we can write as a plus 2 is equal to 6 plus 2. We can cancel 2, 2 and write a equal to 6. That is what is meant by simple cancellation law. Is true for ring structure also. Let us see, for the sake of notations, every time writing dot is not so convenient, so we just neglect a dot, AB we write, A dot B equal to AB. For the sake of convenience, A plus of course minus of B is there, but every time plus of this bracket we ignore and simply write A minus B. Writing A dot A many times, we write A square, A dot A cube or n times A raised to n. So now examples of rings we have seen in our discussions. See, this basic properties are there. Let us prove at least one theorem. So first theorem is A dot 0 equal to 0 dot A equal to 0. How do we prove this? Since R is a group, here R is there. Since R is a group, under addition, 0 is an identity element. A is dot 0 plus 0 equal to A dot 0 plus 0. Why I can write this? Because this 0 is 0 plus 0. So this is nothing but, see, this 0 when I neglect, because A dot 0 is A dot 0 only, but this 0 is written as 0 plus 0. So because of distributive law, A dot 0 plus A dot 0. So this is distributive, you take inside here. You should write the condition. Then by cancellation law, you can cancel A dot 0 both sides, 0 equal to A dot 0 by left cancellation law, which we observed in the remark. Similarly, we can prove the right cancellation law using 0 dot A equal to 0. That proves the first. Similarly, second one is A into minus B equal to minus of A into B equal to minus of AB. Means this minus sign you can take outside. For example, A into minus B plus AB equal to, because of distributive law, you can take this A outside and write minus B plus B. Because of the identity inverse element, you can write 0, A dot 0 equal to 0. So addition of two things equal to 0 implies these two are inverse of each other. Hence, A into minus B is inverse of AB. We write it as A into minus B equal to inverse of, inverse means minus of AB. Similarly, we can prove minus of A into B equal to minus of AB. Similarly, we can prove the third one, minus of minus AB equal to AB, very similar to the second one. See, now fourth one is little different. A plus minus of A plus B is, you can take this minus sign inside to this whole thing. Minus of A plus B is A plus B. That is A plus B plus, if I add these two, because of the associative property, I can combine first B and minus B. Because of the first of all, what? Commutative property, minus B comes over here. Because of associative property, I can add these two. Because of zero property, this becomes zero. Because of zero property, again, this becomes A. Because of negative property, this becomes zero. What we proved? These two are inverse of each other. Therefore, I can write A minus of A plus B is minus A minus B. That is, these two are inverse of each other. Similarly, we can prove fifth and sixth, very, very similar. So some special types of rings we have seen that. So from the definition of ring, we note that the multiplication operation in a ring is just associative. It is imposing some more conditions. If I impose AB equal to BA, it becomes commutative ring. Z, Q, R, C, integers, rational numbers, real numbers, complex numbers are all commutative rings, but matrix is not. Similarly, ring with unity. With respect to multiplication, 1 is unity, so that again all these things are Z, Q, R, C, all are commutative ring with unity. That is, ring with unity, ring with abelian group. But the structure of the matrix has got unity, but that even number set has no unity. That just like we have observed this. So including all these things, first important thing is, what is the difference between commutative ring and unity ring? Whether a commutative ring can be a ring with unity? No. The answer is, why it is no? The question is whether commutative ring is always a ring with unity, and the reverse. I am writing here. Suppose there is a commutative ring, R is commutative ring, whether this implies R is ring with unity. The answer is no. For this answer you should give one example. What is the example? First you take a commutative ring which is suppose even number set minus 4 minus 2 0 2 4. So if you add any two even numbers in any fashion, a plus b equal to b plus a, this belongs to E again. So E is commutative ring. But one doesn't belong to E. So E is not ring with unity. So we answered a simple question here. What is that? A commutative ring R doesn't imply R is rings. I should write doesn't imply, but here I have written no. Why? For that you should take one example. That example is, if I take E equal to, then A plus B equal to B plus A is true, hence it becomes commutative. But 1 is not there, you can see that 1 is an odd number, 1 is not there. You can still write still deeper, if you go 1 is odd number, doesn't belong to A, so it is not a commutative ring, it is not a ring with unity. Hence this implies, is implication is wrong. Whether the reverse is true, whether R with respect to ring with unity implies a commutative ring, just think, no, it is not same. Why it is not same? Take one example for this. Do you remember the example of square matrices? If I take square matrices of order n cross n, then there exists a unit matrix of order, suppose I take 3 cross 3 for my discussion, 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. So that set of all matrices of n cross n order with respect to usual addition and dot of matrices is ring with unity, because it contains, this is sometimes denoted by a 1 also, but doesn't mean that it is commutative ring. No, because many times it is told, but this example you should remember please, many times it is told that since AB is not equal to BA, matrix structure is not abelian, hence with respect to multiplication it is abelian with respect to addition. Let us not get confused, matrix structure is not abelian with respect to multiplication, but with respect to addition it should be abelian, otherwise it will not become ring only. See, in a group, first of all, in a ring, first of all, addition should be commutative. That is, it is a group with respect to addition and abelian group. So we should not write A plus B and B plus A here. Matrix is abelian or commutative with respect to addition. With respect to multiplication, this fails. That is why matrix is not commutative ring. So both of these statements need not imply each other. Sometimes they imply means need not imply. For example, when, for which examples it is true for both? If it is a set of integers, it is a commutative ring also, it is a ring with unity also. It is a set of Q, it is a commutative ring also, it is a ring with unity also. It is a set of complex numbers, it is commutative ring also, set of unity also. So now all these together, they are known as commutative rings with unity. So that if a question is there, prove that the given set is a commutative ring with unity. First of all, we have to prove that it is a group under addition, then associative law with respect to multiplication, then two distributive laws, left distribution, right distribution. Apart from that, prove that it is a commutative with respect to multiplication also, and there is a 1 like structure, maybe this one or usual number 1 like structure in that set, so that it becomes commutative with respect to unity. So two special types of rings we saw here. What is first one is commutative ring, second one is ring with unity. Apart from this, The third one is more interesting, which is known as ring with zero divisors. This is more interesting. Ring with zero divisors means, in number theory what happens, if A into B equal to 0, then either A is 0 or B is 0, like 2 into 0 equal to 0 or 0 into 3 equal to 0, so or 0 into 0 equal to 0, at least one of them is 0. So we have that at least one of them is 0. In some of the structures what happens, though both of them are not zeros, then that time also the product is 0. Very simple example, very simple example. If A and B are two matrices, then product may be 0, then product may be 0. So that A need not be 0, B need not be 0, then these two are known as dividing zeros. A divides 0, B divides 0, they are proper divisors. So, a ring which has got such structures are known as zero divisor ring or ring with zero divisors. Of course, Z is not, integer set is not, real number set is not, this is not, but what is the extra feature of matrix theory? A matrix is a commutative, non-commutative ring with unity, but apart from that, it is a ring with zero divisors. Similarly, we have got one more structure, which is, if we observe this 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, with respect to matrix multiplication and additions, here also we can create, with modulo structures, we can create zero divisors. But let us see these examples, of course, in the next class, whatever we have discussed, revise them, which will be useful to see. Rings and ideals are very well used in our cryptography. These are our application parts. So, ring with a prime number structure also very giving, very smooth structures, very fine structures. So let me highlight these points what we have discussed, because these will be important for you. Especially A dot B is not written as always A dot B A B. A plus minus B is sometimes written as A minus B, and unnecessarily we don't want to write A dot A as A square, A cube we write. Then we proved these important theorems, that is fifth one. If I see, can you see the speciality of fifth one? A into B minus C is AB minus AC, something like distribution only, but you need not always go on doing all these operations independently. Directly we can jump from this. This is a proof itself. A into B minus C, because of this is a minus C is written as plus minus C. This, when you write this plus, no, then only you can write distributions. So hence AB plus A into minus C, because minus C can take out, it is AB minus AC. So like this we have to practice the proofs also. In the next class, let me take some more important structures of ring theory, some more important examples also, and afterwards let us come to the sub ring structures also. So using this sub ring structures, we can even go to what are known as ideals and integral domains and fields also. These are all special qualities, special structures of ring. Let me define sub ring, ideal, fields and integral domain. In that field, without field we cannot proceed what is known as linear algebra. So hence let us hope that you study and come for the next class. And hence these ring structures, what is the difference between groups theory and ring structure, just read once again, and till you meet once again in the ring theory. Bye. Thank you very much. See you.